everybody's Joe Roberts, OneWineDude.com, and this is Jasmine Hirsch, which you'll be familiar with the last name, a very famous producer now in Sonoma. So here we are, in Pursuit of Balance in New York City. And interestingly, last year I came in Pursuit of Balance. I had a lot of Sonoma Coast wines, very far west Sonoma Coast for the most part. This year, this is Mathiasen. So we are branching, although they do take a Sonoma Coast, it's far down. But we are branching out here. So maybe I just want to get a couple thoughts on differences now between when you first started this event and kind of what you're trying to get people, what's the message you're trying to give them with the wines you're selecting, and what's a common thread between them?
Well, probably the biggest thing that's changed is our selection process. So when Raj and I first started in Pursuit of Balance in 2011, we literally sat at the bar at RN74 and wrote names on the back of the napkin.
This is Raj Parr, obviously.
This is Raj Parr, my co-founder of the Pursuit of Balance, also a winemaker and, of course, a sommelier as well. So the first year was very casual. We just said, who belongs here, wish list. And we threw our first event in 2011. And since then, we've actually formalized the selection process. So what that means is, number one, it's
cage
more
match.
Fair. Number one, it's more fair. But also, it means that we are actually, including producers that we wouldn't necessarily have thought of off the bat. And we're also getting the submissions from so many wineries. You know, most of the wineries here you've heard of, but there's also winemakers that you've probably never heard of, especially for the average consumer. And I think that that's what's great about In Pursuit of Balance now, is that there's more diversity within the group, both stylistic, regional, as you mentioned, and also between established names and new names.
So really quick, because she's been on her feet all day. She needs to get a sandwich. Right? Really quick, what's the common thread? So now you've got a selection process. What's a common thread with these wines now that you've brought that selection process?
I think these are wines with incredible integrity. I think, we do not ask people how they make their wines when they go through the selection process to become a member of our organization. But for the most part, what you see in this room, in fact, as far as I know, everybody, these are wines that are unmanipulated. These are people that are pursuing terroir as much as they're pursuing balance. In fact, I would say that balance is simply the prerequisite to be able to make Chardonnays and Pinot Noirs of terroir. So we probably should have called it pursuing terroir. But I think, and I think that there is stylistic diversity, but a lot of these wines are more leaning towards that style of elegance, restraint, high acid, lower alcohol, maybe a little bit less fruit and more earthy characteristics, things like that. That's a generalization because we do have a lot of stylistic differences amongst a lot of our producers.
Well, I can say it's a superb taste.
Thank you, Joe.
No clunkers.
Awesome. That's what we want to hear. You know, if I can answer your question one more time, the answer would be in one word, quality. These wines are not just wines that fit in thematically with In Pursuit of Balance, but they're also some of the best California Pinot Noirs and Chardonnays out there.
Well, there you have it, folks. In Pursuit of Balance. Cheers.